Hey guys, welcome back to our channel Stock My Closet. Today I'm sharing very trendy flared kurti for large size. You can pair it with leggings, culottes, plazo, etc. So let's get started. This is the measurement I'm using. You can adjust it according to your requirement. I'm using 3 meter cotton fabric. Firstly, I'll cut the bodice, and for that I have cut out the required length including seam allowance from the fabric. Total length is 31 inch, 15 inch for front and 15 inch for back. Now I'll cut the required width, and from the leftover fabric I'll cut the sleeves. To cut the required width, we'll take the widest measurement on the bodice, that is bust measurement. In my measurement, bust round is 40 inch and I'll be adding 3 inch of ease. So 40 plus 3 is 43, and dividing it by 4, I'll get 10.75 inch. I'll just take the round figure 11 inch and 1 inch of seam allowance. So 11 plus 1 is 12 inch. So I need 12 inch width on fold. If you are measuring single layer, then make it double, 24 inch. So this is 12 inch and I'll just cut it out. And from this fabric I'll make sleeves. Now I'll fold the fabric by half in length and then in width. As you can see, the print on this fabric is directional. Leaves are facing upwards, but on the other side, leaves are facing downwards. So we need to change the direction. And for that, cut the on-fold side. So I've separated front and back side. Now change the direction. Now leaves are facing upwards on both front and back side. Now I'll mark the measurements. Length of bodice is 15 inch. Extend this point. Now for shoulder, take half of shoulder width. In my measurement, shoulder width is 15 inch, so half of it will be 7.5 inch. Neck width is 3 inch. Mark half inch downward for shoulder slope and join it to the neck width point. From this point, I'll mark half of armhole round, that is 7.5 inch for my measurement. I'll just extend this point. Mark 0.75 inch inwards and join it to the shoulder slope point. From the top, I'll mark a point at 11.5 inch shoulder to apex. Now I'll mark the round measurements. For chest, I'm adding 2 inch of ease. In my measurement, chest round is 37 inch. 37 plus 2 is 39, and dividing it by 4, I'll get 9.75 inch. For bust, I'm adding 3 inch of ease. In my measurement, bust round is 40 inch. 40 plus 3 is 43, and dividing it by 4, I'll get 10.75 inch. For waist, I'm adding 3 inch of ease. In my measurement, waist round is 33 inch, 33 plus 3 is 36, and dividing it by 4, I'll get 9 inch. Now I'll join these points. Adding 1 inch of seam allowance. Now I'll draw armhole curves. Now I'll mark neckline measurements. Front neck depth is 8 inch. Back neck depth is 6 inch. Again mark neck width point and join these points. Now I'll just cut the bodies. Back neck width is same 3 inch, depth is 6 inch. For back, I'm making round shape. And for front, I'll make V in round shape. So bodice cutting is completed. Now I'll cut the bottom. For bottom, I'm cutting half circle skirt. To cut the skirt, I have cut out required length, which will be full length minus bodice length. In my measurement, full length is 46 inch, bodice length is 15 inch. So 46 minus 15 is 31. Now we need to add radius and seam allowance to length measurement. Radius will be waist round plus ease and divided by 3.14. In my measurement, waist round is 33 inch and I'm adding 3 inch of ease. 33 plus 3 is 36 and dividing it by 3.14, I'll get 11.5 inch. So total required length will be 31 inch plus 11.5 inch plus 1 inch for seam allowance. So this is 43.5 inch. So total length of this fabric is 43.5 inch and we need the same width as well. So keep this in mind while buying the fabric, because you can change the length but you cannot change the width of fabric. So calculate this measurement before buying the fabric. Now from the top corner, I'll mark the radius, that is 11.5 inch, and I'll mark the same till the other end. Leaving half inch of seam allowance. Now from this point, I'll mark the length. Measure the same from the top. This is 43 inch. Now again, mark the same measurement till the other end. So marking is complete. Now I'll cut it. So I've cut the bottom, now I'll cut the sleeves. I'm using the same leftover fabric and I've folded the fabric by half in width. Sleeve length is 15 inch. Cap height is 3.5 inch. From the top, mark a point at 6 inch and 11 inch. This is shoulder to elbow to give proper fitting to sleeves. Extend cap height and length points. Now for cap width, divide bust measurement by 4 and deduct 1 inch out of it. Like in my measurement, bust round is 40 inch and dividing it by 4, I'll get 10. And 10 minus 1 is 9 inch, so I'll mark a point at 9 inch. Join it to the shoulder point. Now measure and divide this line into 3 parts. Mark half inch upwards and half inch downwards. Now I'll draw back and front armhole curves, taking these points as guidelines. Now I'll mark the sleeve round points at 6 inch, 11 inch and 15 inch. Measure sleeve round. Add ease of 1 inch or 2 inch as per your choice. Divide it by 2 and mark the same on the sleeves. Now I'll join these points. Adding seam allowance. Now I'll cut it. And with this, cutting off my kurti is completed. I'll share its stitching in my next video. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you like this video. If you do, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And I'll see you soon. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.